How do you set the browser zoom in Playwright? Okay, I've got this e-commerce store set up, and there's an element that only shows up when the zoom is set to like 90%. You could say, hey, that's not great web design, and I'd agree, but nonetheless, it happens. How do we get our Playwright script to match this zoom setting? Okay, so there isn't a Playwright API call for this. In the meantime, we can do pretty well with page.evaluate, which is like the equivalent of running commands in the browser console. Page.evaluate goes a lot further than that. Actually, it'll return stuff from the JavaScript engine running in the browser up to Playwright, which is very, very neat. But for right now, we're just going to do it like we're running something in the JavaScript console for the browser. What we could do is we can set the document.body.style.zoom. And this is kind of a kludge. This is setting the CSS zoom, not the browser zoom. But the effect is super similar, and since not every browser implements zoom identically, it's a pretty good placeholder. And my IDE is going to complain a little bit because it doesn't realize this code will be evaluated by the browser. So it's like, hey, this code maybe can't get run by Playwright. That's fine. So we will get that red underline here. So now that we've got the zoom set to 0.8 or 80%, yeah, now that toolbar is loading in for the test. Perfect. Hey, maybe it's not obvious that the zoom value is different. Maybe you don't remember it from the beginning of this video. So let's set it way down to 10% so you can really see it. Okay, let's run this test. And yeah, there it is, super teeny tiny. Okay, so why can't Playwright set the zoom natively? Isn't the goal to simulate anything a user might do? This is an open issue with the Playwright project. If you want to go check it out, I'll link it in the video description. There's even a module available on NPM that handles it super elegantly. Okay, what other ways can we simulate this issue? Well, beyond zooming elements, we can set the viewport. Up here at the top, you can do test.use and set the viewport. Which will squish things down or let things grow. This most often gets used as a cheap and cheerful way of simulating a mobile device. So you see, you get that kind of nice mobile device viewport here. There are better ways to simulate a mobile device in Playwright, and I'll tell you all about them in my next video. Okay, one thing to be aware of, one last thing. Messing with CSS zoom can cause some mistakes in click detection with Playwright. At least it's reported all over the GitHub issue. I wasn't able to make that happen, but again, it's reported all over the place, so do watch out for that if you're trying this.